Un jour, vers midi, du côté du parc Monceau, sur la plateforme arrière d'un autobus à peu près complet de la ligne S, aujourd'hui 84, j'aperçus un personnage au cou fort long qui portait un feutre mou entouré d'un galon tressé au lieu de ruban. Cet individu interpella tout à coup son voisin en prétendant que celui-ci faisait exprès de lui marcher sur les pieds chaque fois qu'il montait ou descendait des voyageurs. Il abandonna d'ailleurs rapidement la discussion pour se jeter sur une place devenue libre. 2 heures plus tard, je le revis devant la gare Saint-Lazare en grande conversation avec un ami qui lui conseillait de diminuer l'échancrure de son pardessus en faisant remonter le bouton supérieur par quelques tailleurs compétents.
Bonsoir tout le monde et bienvenue à Our Song d'Hiver. This is going to be a fantastic concert with soprano Mireille Asselin and pianist Frédéric Lacroix. Welcome back to our 2021 season, immune to cancellation. If you're new to Tapestry, please join us at our website for a free membership where you can access all of our concerts and operas and opera shorts. Today it's my great pleasure to share the room with Mireille Asselin and the artistic director of our partner in this beautiful concert, Laetitia Delamar from Alliance Française. How are you guys doing?
Good. Thank you for having us here for this evening of French-ish music.
Yeah, thank you so much for having us, Michael, and merci beaucoup. Ça me fait très plaisir d'être avec vous.
Mireille, what's your background?
Well, I'm actually half American and half French-Canadian. So my father is Québécois from Montreal. My mom is from upstate New York in the States. And I was born in Ottawa, which is a very bilingual place, as most people know. But I grew up on the east coast of Canada in New Brunswick. Donc, j'étais une Acadienne adoptée quand j'étais jeune. J'ai déménagé au Nouveau-Brunswick quand j'avais 5 ans. Et une fois arrivée au Nouveau-Brunswick, j'étais immédiatement enveloppée dans la culture acadienne, la musique acadienne, l'accent acadien. But I always loved this idea of being une Acadienne adoptée. it's something that's really commonly sort of said and embraced in that community. And I found that to be such a beautiful sort of accepting way to think of people who are welcomed into your home, into your culture. And the thing that I think one of the reasons I still feel really grounded in that culture, even though I moved away when I was in eighth grade, was, I mean, you always feel very grounded in the place that you grew up, but, you know, every town, chaque personne avait son accent différent, avait son identité unique. Chaque petit village avait un accent acadien unique, différent, coloré. Et je trouvais ça vraiment, c'était un endroit chaleureux, un endroit musical. La langue était très musicale, l'accent musical. And so that's where I wanted to sort of start the program, is to celebrate a little bit of some especially folk influence from the East Coast of Canada and the Acadian community out there. So you'll hear a few things, and a special guest also from l'Acadie. We'll bring in un vrai de vrai Acadien pour vous parler. Allô Maxime, merci de te joindre à nous aujourd'hui. C'est un plaisir. Donc, raconte-nous un peu. Toi, tu es un guitariste et tu habites en Nouvelle-Écosse, dans une communauté acadienne qui s'appelle Chétican. C'est bien ça?
C'est ça, oui. C'est un petit village acadien au Cap-Breton. J'ai grandi là pour toute mon enfance. Puis là, j'ai été à l'université à Halifax, mais là, je suis de retour à Chétican les dernières années. Okay. Et c'est juste un petit village d'environ peut-être 3000 personnes qui est entouré avec des communautés écossaises. Mm. Et de façon musicale, comme qui est évident dans la pièce qui va jouer dans le spectacle, c'est il y a une grosse influence écossaise dans notre musique, spécialement dans la musique instrumentale. Il y a un répertoire de chansons françaises aussi là, mais c'est un peu un mélange des deux à Chétican.
Can you introduce the piece that we're going to hear next?
Oh, yeah, sure. So the piece that you're about to hear is a group of two jigs, the first of which is Monday Morning Jig, which was written by a friend of mine, and he was also my guitar prof at Dalhousie. His name is Scott McMillan. And after that's an old traditional tune that I believe is Irish originally, but it's kind of been adopted and played in Celtic circles all over the world, Morrison's Jig.
Dor. Est-ce que ça se peut, un léopard qui parle? Je suis très petite.
Fred, ça fait presque 20 ans qu'on se connaît?
En effet.
Oui. On va faire les calculs là-dessus. Donc, ce soir, on va présenter les Wednesday Night Haiku que tu as écrits en 2003, c'est ça?
C'est ça.
Peux-tu raconter un peu l'histoire des Wednesday Night Haiku? Can you tell people about this piece and where it came from?
Bien, il y a à peu près une vingtaine d'années, j'étais coach vocal pour ta prof, Yuriko Tano-Kimmins, qui était une pédagogue importante à Ottawa. Et puis, cette année-là, j'avais 8 super chanteuses, dont toi, avec qui j'adorais travailler. Et puis, à la fin, pour souligner une année de travail qui était fantastique, j'ai décidé d'écrire 8 courtes mélodies pour chacune des chanteuses.
It's been so long that I've wanted to perform these with you because they were such a beautiful gift nearly 20 years ago, and we've just never had the chance to do it. So I'm really excited to be able to share it with everybody.
Well, I'm really thrilled as well to share it tonight.
Plus, we get a bonus Fred Lacroix arrangement of Les Raffemans that we'll hear right after.
Yes, that was
hot off the presses.
Hot off the press, just for this show.
Okay.
And maybe some other shows after.
We'll see.
We'll see.
Okay.
Oh, Ça y est, je sors du placard. Je le dis, je suis bi. Bilingue, biculturelle, binomale, bien nommée. Marie-Claire, un deuxième prénom pour mes deux familles, mes racines. Marie pour Marie, for Marion, my granny man. Claire, comme de l'eau. Like Clarence, my grandfather, maternel. Mes mots, mes langues s'entremêlent. Si longtemps défendu la langue de mon père, mes sources ottaviennes, franco-ontariennes pour ne pas me perdre dans la mer. Puis, soudain, la langue de ma mère, redécouverte. J'ai des souvenirs partagés avec les autres, les Anglos. Mes sources torontoises, ou même américaines, Sharon, Lois, Bram, Bibi, Geneviève, chansons, histoires, comptines partagées, divisées, unies chez moi. Bi. Bi. By the power of love, I was born to two worlds. My friends spoke one language or the other, or both, no matter. We shared a common language of play and wonder. And today I find my mind wanders from one to another, no matter. I play with words. Sounds. Les mots qu'il faut sont là pour moi. Les mots s'emportent, je flotte parmi leurs sons. And the sounds astound my ears, my tongue, my bicultural tongues. Bilingual. Bifocal. Trying to focus and find my way, sometimes I stumble. Try to assimilate and choose, confused. Je cherche qui je suis, je fuis la vérité. Moi, comme unique, comme unique. Je fais deux. Two worlds. Words collide. Collusion, collision d'idées, de pensées, fusion de cultures et de thèmes. Et je t'aime. Toi, ma ville, ma capitale. Tu es comme moi, à cheval sur deux rives qui s'esquivent et se retrouvent. Ville bilingue qui n'ose s'avouer. It's your turn, my dearest, to come out of your closet, to admit you are also bilingual, biculturel. Founded by the English, the Irish, and the Scots. Par les Canadiens français. Ils sont tous là, tous les raftsmen. Ils t'ont aimé, t'ont baptisé, ma ville chérie. Here they drank, there they fought, here they stayed. Ont fondé a rough shanty town, rife with strife. De ville sans foi ni loi devenue capitale verte, qui n'ose s'avouer bilingue, bicultural. Et me voici, ottavienne au fond de l'âme, voyageuse au long cours, amalgame. Artiste, créatrice qui s'affirme enfin, qui sort de son placard et qui dit, qui écrit et qui crie qui je suis. I am not one, I am many. At least two, maybe three or four. Pues dentro de mi alma sueña una mujer castellana. Y a veces en mi mente las palabras de esa época lejana. Resuenan. Et dans mon corps, l'appel du mouvement, de la danse, se fait parfois aussi fort que les mots qui dansent dans ma tête. Mais, avant tout, envers et contre tout, je suis, I am, bi.
Hi Ian, bonjour.
Bonjour,
merci
ça va bien?
De te joindre à nous. Oui, ça va toi?
Ça va, oui.
OK. Donc, for those of you watching at home, this is Ian Cusson. He's a fantastic Canadian composer of French and Métis descent. And he, I just had to add some of his music on this program because he's so great. And I'm really glad that he could join us virtually for this little intro. Ian, can you tell us a little bit about yourself, your French roots, and how that plays into how you write your music?
Totally. Yeah, I come from a really interesting community on Georgian Bay, which is in Ontario. And it's interesting because there's a tiny community within called La Fontaine, where my mother was born. And it is a little French pocket of French-speaking people in essentially a sea of English. I grew up with a mother whose first language, sa langue maternelle, est français. Et mon papa, il parle anglais seulement. So I grew up in this home of the confluence of two languages. But on top of that, it's a thing. It's a real thing, right?
Mm-hmm.
And And also, like, I also grew up at the confluence of French and or French culture, but also Métis culture, which is very influenced in our little neck of the woods by the French community and the Roman Catholic community. And oftentimes I think about the threads of those things. They are mixed together and intersect in ways that I don't always know where one piece begins and where it ends.
Mm-hmm. Donc, est-ce que tu peux nous raconter un peu, c'était quoi l'inspiration pour les chansons qu'on va entendre aujourd'hui, la poésie en particulier, qu'est-ce qui t'a attiré à la poésie?
Well, you know, what was really, I've always loved the poetry of Émile Nelligan. As a child, I read especially the more Le Vaisseau d'Or and some of the really famous poems. Soirée d'hiver is another one that everybody has to read. But I was, about 5 years ago, I was in Montreal and I was in a bookstore and I was going through the poetry section and reading, looking for interesting French poetry that might be an inspiration to some musical settings. And I came across his œuvre complète. And I bought the book and I read everything that he wrote and thought, wow, there's this incredible language. And sadly, I think in Canada, we know Émile Nelligan's story, in particular, the story that he was quite prodigious at a young age, around 16. He started 15, 16. He was writing poetry and presenting it in Montreal. But then he had a nervous breakdown around 20. And he was institutionalized and then never wrote any new work after that for the next 45 years of his life. So we know the story of Nelligan, but this poetry I wanted to find a way to explore through song. One really interesting thing when I was researching and reading about Nelligan's life at the time I was writing these songs was to discover that there are a lot of opinions as to why he had this mental breakdown. Some of them feel like he had unrecorded feelings with his own sexuality. But there are some theories that are about that he lived in this space between English and French. And of course, he had an English father and a French-speaking mother. And that this pressure of being between worlds was actually what led to his mental breakdown. This is one of many theories, but I think it's an interesting thought for those of us who do live at these intersectional points of either between languages or between cultures, to imagine what the impacts of that place of being can be on us.
Oh,
rage des sanglots.
Gardons-y-moi, tout le monde, la, 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 Thank you.
thank you so much, everyone, for coming, and congratulations to Mireille and Fred. Learn more about l'Alliance Française on their website, or if you can follow them on Instagram. They have all kinds of wonderful things coming up, and they do theater as well as music. Lots of beautiful programming. Connect to Alliance Française.
Merci à tous. Merci beaucoup, Mireille et Frédéric. Et avant de vous quitter, je voudrais vous dire que vous pouvez évidemment suivre toute la programmation de Tapestry Opera en allant sur leur site internet à tapestryopera.com. Donc, so don't forget to follow Tapestry Opera. So you just have to check out all of their events on tapestryopera.com.
Merci tout le monde.
Bonne soirée à tous.
Bonne soirée.
Bonne soirée à tous.
Thank you everyone and have a lovely evening. We'll see you next time.